Okay, good morning students. So last class we discussed about the moving charges and magnetism. Moving charges and magnetism. And what is the Biot Savart law? And expression for the magnetic induction due to a long straight charge connecting wire and the circular loop etc. we discussed in last class. Okay, so today discuss that topic. So that is called as the magnetic induction. Moving charges and magnetism. So that is means we have taken the current carrying the circular loop. So this is called as a current carrying circular loop. Okay. So now we have taken the center of the circle is taken O. Okay. So the current passing through it is I. Okay. So the moving charges and magnetism, 7th chapter. So what is the Biot Savart law and the magnetic induction to find out the current carrying straight conductor. Okay, so now here the given the current is passing through the conductor. Okay, so the circular coil. Okay, so to find out the magnetic induction at the center of the coil, okay, so magnetic induction at the center of the coil, so here taken that is the radius is taken, that is called as a R, and the small element is taken, that is called as a DL. Okay, so this is called as a current carrying circular coil. I be the current carrying circular coil, R be the radius of the coil. And so to find out the expression for the magnetic induction at the center of the coil, got it. So magnetic induction at the center of the coil by using Biot-Savart law. Okay. So now consider the coil, the circular coil, the current passing through the circular coil I. And the radius of the coil is R. And so the magnetic induction, so dB is find out it. And the dl is a small element is taken on the circular coil, that is called as a dl. Okay, so now by using the Biot Savart law, so according to the Biot Savart law, so dB is equal to mu naught by 4 pi I dl sin theta by R square. Okay, so mu naught by 4 pi I dl sin theta by R square. So that is called as a according to based on Biot Savart law. Here the dl is a small element. So the dB is the magnetic induction at the center of the coil. So the magnetic induction dB, take the distance R due to the dl. Okay, due to the dl. But to find out the total circular coil find out. But only dl is to form the magnetic induction dB, take the distance from R. Okay, got it. So the magnetic induction dB, so mu naught by 4 pi I dl sin theta by R square. Okay, so here the dB is equal sin theta. So sin theta means here angle is taken 90 degrees. Okay, so dl and R is the 90 degrees. So 90 degrees because sin theta is equal 1. Okay, so we can write the equation mu naught by 4 pi I dl by R square we can write. Now totally we can find the total resultant magnetic induction. Magnetic induction due to the circular coil. So the resultant magnetic induction due to the circular coil, so on both sides integrating is taken. Okay, so now here integrating, so integrating of dB is equal to integrating of mu naught by 4 pi I dl by r square. Okay, got it. So for example, integral of dx is equal to x, integral of dx is equal to s. Okay, so integral of dv is equal to b. Okay, so mu naught by 4 pi is the constant, mu naught by 4 pi is the constant, and so remaining equation I is the constant, r square is the constant, remaining integral of dl. So integral of dl is equal to l. Okay, so v is equal mu naught I by 4 pi r square. Okay, integral of dl is equal to l. L is means, so that is called as the total length of the circle is taken, that is called as a 2 pi r. Okay, got it. So now substituting l plus 2 pi r, so v is equal to mu naught I by 4 pi r square into l. L is equal to 2 pi r, r is the radius. So r r cancel, 2 2 jar, pi pi cancel. So remaining equation we get, so mu naught I by 2 r square. Okay, so this is called as a magnetic induction at the center of the coil. Magnetic induction at the center of the coil. So mu naught I by 2 r square. If you consider the number of the turns is taken, number of turns is taken, that is called as a n into mu naught into I by 2 r square. I is the current passing through the circular coil, r be the radius. Okay, so magnetic induction at the center of the coil, mu naught I by 2 r square. Consider the circular coil. Okay, consider the circular coil. The center of the circular coil is O, and so this is called as an axis is taken. This is called as a pin point. Okay, so the magnetic induction. Okay, to find out the magnetic induction, current carrying circular loop axis. Okay, so this is called as on the axis. So now we are taking the axis, the point is taken, the distance P, the current is passing through the I. Okay, so this is taken here, dl is the small length, dl. Okay, dl. Okay, so dl is called as a small length. So the taken the distance here r, and the radius of the circular coil is capital R. Okay, so the angle is taken theta. Okay, got it. So here the axis is extended, so this is called as a x-axis, and so we have taken, that is called as a so cos theta, here sin theta. dv sin theta and dv cos theta, dv cos theta. Okay, so we have taken, so this is called as a, so to find out the magnetic induction on axis of the current carrying circular loop. Okay, so the magnetic induction, to find out the magnetic induction, so the current carrying circular loop is taken on the axis. Okay, so this is called as a point P is taken, that is the distance is x from the center of the coil. So consider the coil, so the coil, the current passing through the coil is I. Okay, so consider the circular coil, the current passing through the current is I, and so the taken the point P, so to find out the magnetic induction dB. Okay, to find out the magnetic induction dB at a point P, take the distance x from the center of the circular coil. And so the radius of the coil is taken capital R. And small r is the taken the distance between the small element to P point. Small L point to L, small d, small p, small r is the P point to dl. And here the dp is divided two components. One is the horizontal component and another is called as a vertical component. Here also using the Biot-Savart law. Okay, by using the Biot-Savart law. So now here taken, so this is called as a current carrying the circular loop I. And the radius of the circular coil is R. I am to find out the magnetic induction dB, take the distance x from the center of the coil. So small r is the distance between the small element to P point. So the magnetic induction is divided in two components, vertical component, horizontal component. So vertical component, horizontal component divided. Okay. By using the Biot-Savart law, so the dB is equal to mu naught by 4 pi I dl sin theta by r square. Okay, so dB is equal to mu naught by 4 pi I dl sin theta by r square. Got it. So here the sin theta is equal 90 degrees. Okay, sin theta is equal 90 degrees. So sin 90 is equal 1. So remaining equation we can write dB is equal to mu naught by 4 pi I dl by r square. So theta is equal 90 degrees. So sin 90 is equal 1. Okay, got it. But here, so the dB is divided in a two components, horizontal, vertical. So here, there is called as a vertical components are cancelled to each other. And only the horizontal components are added. Only horizontal components is added. A horizontal component is taken, that is called as a dB sin theta. So this is called as a horizontal component. Horizontal component added. Okay, so that is called as a dB sin theta. So dB sin theta, so dB already to find out. So mu naught by 4 pi I dl by r square into sin theta is taken. Okay, sin theta. So ready kada. Here taken, that is called as a horizontal component. Horizontal component dB sin theta. So dB is equal to mu naught by 4 pi I dl by r square into sin theta. Okay, got it. So that is called as a magnetic induction. Only the vertical components are cancelled with each other. Only take a horizontal component. So that is the dB sin theta. So dB already find out it. And sin theta is substituted. Okay, got it. So now here the sin theta is the, that is taken so I dl, so the integrating on both sides. So integrating on both sides, we can write is taken. So mu naught by 4 pi idl by r square sin theta. So sin theta is equal. So sin theta is equal opposite side by hypotenuse. Opposite side by hypotenuse. So sin theta is equal r by r is taken. R by r. And so this is called as a integration is taken on both sides. So this is called as a dB is equal. Okay. So B is equal. So mu naught by 4 pi. R square is also constant and I is also constant. So integration of dl sin theta. Okay, dl sin theta. So b is equal to mu naught by 4 pi I r square. Dl is equal, l is taken, sin theta. Sin theta is equal r by r. Okay, got it. So b is equal to mu naught by 4 pi I r square. R square is taken here. What is the r square? That means mu naught by 4 pi I dl sin theta by r square. R square is taken. This pole is a capital R. Okay, now so study capital R. Capital R square. Here also like the capital R square, capital R square, capital R square. So capital R square. Okay, into it is equal 2 pi r. Okay, 2 pi r into r by r. Got it. Okay. So R is cancer. 2 ja, 5 cancer. So remaining question we get, so B is equal mu naught I R by 2 R square. It is called as a, we have taken. So that is called as a x is taken. Okay. So the distance is taken, x square is taken. Okay. So now substituting here x square. Okay. R square by here distance not a capital R. So that is called as a x square. Here also x square. Here also x square. Okay, so not cancel. Here means mu naught I R square by 2. Okay, 2 pi R. That is called as 2 pi R. Okay, integral of L is called 2 pi R. Got it. R by R. So opposite side by hypotenuse. And mu naught I R square by x square. Okay, so mu naught I R square by 2x square. Okay, got it. So x square means, so here this is called as x square. So according to Pythagoras series, so x square is equal to r square plus small r square. So b is equal mu naught I r square into 2 into x square r square plus capital r square. Okay, got it. So this is called as a final equation of the magnetic induction. Final equation of the magnetic induction on the axis of the circular current carrying loop. Okay, got it. So B is called mu naught I R square by 2 R square plus R square. Okay, got it. Okay, right. So now given that is called as B is equal mu naught I R square by 2 R square plus R square. X is equal. So x is equal r square, x square is equal r square plus r square. X is equal under root of r square plus r square. X is equal r square plus r square whole to the power of 1 by 2. Okay, whole to the power of 1 by 2. So now substituting, so x plus, now substituting x plus. So B is equal mu naught I R square by 2 R square plus R square. So that is means x square, x is equal R square. So R square. That is means so whole to the power of 3 by 2 substituting. Okay, R square plus R square. Whole to the power of 3 by 2. Okay. So that is called as x is equal under root. Under root is nothing but 1 by 2. Okay, r square plus r square. Whole to the power of 3 by 2. Okay, x is equal r square plus r square. And here substituting x square. Okay, x square means so already square we know that. Okay, so substituting we get mu naught I R square by 2 R square plus R square whole to the power of 3 by 2. Okay, got it. Okay, so now in this case if we take a number of terms n into mu naught I R square by 2 R square plus R square whole to the power of 3 by 2 substituting. So this is called as the total magnetic induction on the axial end of the circular current loop. So now to find out the magnetic dipole moment of a current loop. Magnetic dipole moment. So the magnetic dipole moment M. So M is equal NIA is the proof. So magnetic dipole moment of current loop. Okay. So magnetic dipole moment of current loop. Magnetic dipole moment of current loop. So now by using the equation, so if we scale, if we consider, so the R square, R is the very, that is the X. Okay, So this one is a r square plus r square. Okay, r square means x square, r square over the power of 3 by 2. So x is greater than greater than greater than compared to r. So b is equal mu naught I r square by 2 x square square, x cube is taken. Okay, got it. So this is called as a magnetic dipole moment. Magnetic dipole moment, magnetic. So this is called as magnetic induction. Magnetic induction on axis of current carrying. Current carrying circular coil. Circular coil. Okay, current carrying circular coil. Magnetic induction on axis of current carrying circular coil. So if in the case of so x is greater than r, so b is equal mu naught I r square by 2 x cube. Now so this equation, so multiply or divided with respect to 2 pi 2 pi. Okay, so b is equal mu naught by 2 into 2 4 pi. Okay, so 2 pi multiplying. So I r square pi by x cube. Okay, so a is equal pi r square, that is the area. Area is equal pi r square of the circle. So pi r square. Okay, pi r square. Now substituting is capital R. So b is equal u naught 4 pi I, it is called the pi r square is means a into x cube. Okay. So n is also including adding n is means number of turns. So now we are given n is the number of turns, I is the current passing the circular loop, r is the radius, okay, x is the distance. Now so here also b is equal n mu naught I a by 4 by x cube. So but magnetic induction of bar magnet b is equal mu naught by 4 pi mu by x cube okay. So this is called as a this equation is to find out the so the magnetic induction on the axis of the current carrying circular loop. Current carrying circular loop or circular coil. Okay. Circular loop or circular coil. So that is called as a so B is equal n mu naught I a by 4 pi x cube. So this is called as equation 1. But already we know that magnetic induction of a bar magnet. Bar magnet is a so that is not the so that is the magnetic induction ante so b is equal mu naught by 4 pi mu by x cube. Okay, this is called as a equation 2. So comparing of these equation 1 and 2, so we get so m is equal mu naught by 4 pi. Okay, so the n is always taken n or n is not used. So mu naught by 4 pi x cube. So I a n, so the m is equal n I a. So this is called as a magnetic, okay, this is called as a magnetic dipole moment of a current loop. So magnetic dipole moment m is equal n I a. N is nothing but number of terms, I is the current passing, a is means pi r square area. Area is pi r square. Okay, so m is equal n I a is the magnetic dipole moment. Magnetic dipole moment of a current loop. Okay, so this is called as a magnetic induction. So this is called as a magnetic dipole, m is equal n I a. Okay, got it. So further discuss the chapter next class. Okay, thank you students.